We started by picking up all these thousands of fragments of bones and bagging them and labeling them.
Well, the plan of attack is to protect the specimen first of all, and then you go above the specimen and dig down to it so that you can get all the way around it to remove it from the cliff.
Basically use these ditch digging tools, picks and shovels, to dig down that 30 feet from where I thought we could get back into the cliff face far enough to uncover what I thought would be the limits of that skeleton.
Probably the hardest work I've ever had to do in my life. We were doing this all in temperatures around 115 degrees every day.
It was very hard work, but it was very easy to put in a lot of energy into it because we all wanted to see what the skeleton was going to look like.
Basically, we'd take different sections so we weren't in each other's way and just kind of work the specimen until we could start removing bones.
You know, and every time somebody found a bone or a fragment, they just said the S bone. We wouldn't say skull. We didn't want to jinx it.
Early on, I hit something hard, so I stopped. It's the S word, I said, thinking, I bet I hit the skull. When I got down digging and then started really working with a smaller knife, we found, as we were going down, is the back of the skull. Down, and here's this skull taking shape, and we get out on the side, and I put Terry to work on cleaning the side of the skull because he's really our best preparator.
Pete let me work on part of the skull in the field, which was amazing.
He's working and uncovering the teeth one by one by one.
It was spectacular. Teeth like this. Just sticking right out of the skull.
Oh my God, look at this thing. Look how huge it is. This has got to be bigger than the one at the American Museum. It's huge. It's wonderful. We had started a long time ago naming particular dinosaurs, and the name Sue for Susan Hendrickson goes down in history, and I think that's a kind of a cool way to reward those amateurs who make these discoveries.
We're all experienced diggers, and it was just total focused effort. We would just work into the specimen, remove things that we could, protect the rest of it, and then take it out of the ground to get it back into the laboratory where you can have a more controlled environment to take care of the specimen.
The amount of new things that we found and the amount of scientific information that we discovered while finding Sue was enormous.
Beautifully preserved, articulated skull, articulated vertebral column up to the pelvis with the tail and shoulder blade and all this stuff, and it's just like, holy cow, and wonderful preservation. Just fantastic bones that were just beautiful surface on them.
Every time we were ready to take a bone out, or every time there was some new discovery, Pete would take his butcher paper out. He mapped each and every bone, one on one, that we found that was excavated. Discussions, what would be fair.